everyone, and welcome to Homeschool Peace. I'm Cassandra. I'm a mother of three young kids that I homeschool. Today, I wanted to share with you the language arts curriculum that we use in our home. For language arts, I'm talking about things like reading, phonics, spelling, handwriting, vocabulary. And in front of me right now is Logic of English Foundations Program. Now, this looks like a lot in front of me, but please know this is levels A through D in foundations, which is really 4 through 7 year olds or even up to 8 year olds. And it's going to be your pre-K through first or second grade. When I was selecting what type of program I wanted to do for my kids, I wanted to make sure my kids had a program that really taught them the reason why behind the words. That they weren't just learning how to memorize words, that they were able to phonetically sound out words and know what the different meanings of the words were and be able to help them when reading larger words and bigger books. So today, this is just an overview of the program. I plan to dive down deeper into each of these programs and levels as we go through, but today it's just I'm going to focus on the overview of the program and why I chose it. So starting here, the very first level is Foundations Level A. Now A and all these levels, they come with a teacher manual and a workbook. Now in the teacher manual, you have both manuscript and cursive writing options. So you as the parent can select when ordering your workbook for your student if you would like to do cursive or manuscript. Now, Logic of English actually suggests that you do cursive first. They say it's so much easier to teach a child. Start on that baseline, make that cursive letter for their lowercase letters versus for manuscript, a manuscript lowercase letter can range on baseline, top line, midline, or where it starts. It can be a little confusing for the child. So when I selected the Foundations Level A, to be honest, I wasn't really sure about the cursive. I was already doing some manuscript with my kids prior to starting the program, so I made the choice to go ahead and go manuscript. That being said, looking through the teacher manual, because you can see the cursive as you go along, I can definitely see how I think my kid could have actually done cursive, even starting at 4 years old. I really think they could have. It definitely makes it easy and very approachable for the teacher. In Level A's workbook, what's really great is they have readers that the kid is going to create. So these little readers, they're able to stick pictures on and learn how to read those words. The Level A includes the single letter phonograms. So really what it's covering in A is single letter phonograms, as well as teaching the kid how to write their lowercase level letters. Now, single letter phonograms, what do I mean by that? So when my kid was learning to read prior to jumping into this A program, we would learn that like the letter I would say its short sound I and I, and that's it. So whenever he was reading other words and he didn't know, wait, why is it saying why is the I saying a different sound? I really wasn't able to explain it well to him. So this program teaches them that no, I doesn't just say two sounds, it actually says 4 sounds. It says I, I, E, and ya. So whenever they'd read a word that the Y was actually saying its ya sound, I was able to explain, that's the 4th sound. So in Level A, after they learn all their single letter phonograms, they learn to be able to write their lowercase letters, they then are able to start reading some very simple, easy readers. Now, additionally, in this Level A, you also have the Doodling Dragons book. This is a really fun book, colorful pictures, and it has the phonograms, the single letter phonograms that they're learning as part of A. Now, jumping into Level B, let's say your kid already knows single letter phonograms and how to write their lowercase letters. You can jump into B, but in B, the teacher manual does have a sort of a intro that's in the part of the teacher guide that reviews those single letter phonograms as well as making sure your child can write the lowercase letters. So if you're planning to skip A and say would jump right into B based on your kid's age, I would highly recommend that you make sure your kid knows those single letter phonograms and knows how to write those lowercase letters. So jumping into B, B is going to start your multi-letter phonograms. So something like EA. EA says E-A-A, so it's 3 sounds it makes. Those are the types of things that the child is going to learn in B, and they're going to be able to decode words that aren't just single letters. I've noticed for my kids, when they get from out of A and into B, all of a sudden their reading does skyrocket. They're able to go from just able to read little readers to then they're able to read more of the books that you might have on your shelf right now, little step readers or Bob books. They're able to pick those up. The level B does not include the child making their own books, but does include and starts using readers. And these little readers have simple words. They're going to reinforce whatever multi-letter phonograms that they are learning as part of the B program. Additionally, you can also purchase the Young Artist series. It's a separate sort of standalone readers based on the phonograms that they're learning in B, and it's just another way to reinforce those phonograms. With level B, they have a book called Whistling Whales, and Whistling Whales is really great too. Lots of colorful pictures, and it uses those phonograms, especially some of the phonograms that has, you know, three or four sounds in words, and being able to see those in three or four different words of how those sounds being used. As part of the program, you also have multi-letter phonogram flashcards. You use these all the time for reviewing the phonograms throughout the week and when you're going through your lessons. With both levels A and B, you also get these game cards. The game cards are great because you can play, even in any of the levels, you can play Memory Match, Go Fish, just fun games with your kids, and they don't really even know that they're really doing school. Instead, they just are having fun with you, but they're practicing and reinforcing those phonograms. So now moving from level A, B, now into C. Now C is going to be it's the same sort of trend as what you saw in B. Now back in B, you were learning your uppercase letters. And so now you've learned your lowercase and then your uppercase in A and B, whether in cursive or manuscript. And then in the book C, it doesn't come with a manuscript or a cursive. Instead, what they want you to do is they have book-faced words, and they have the student either write in manuscript or write in cursive. Whatever they've done through A and B is then what they use in C. So everyone uses the same C book. And then C has, again, the readers that the kid reads as part of their lessons as they learn the new phonograms. There's also the Miles and Jack book. These books really give the kids a sort of a longer story that they can read based on the phonograms they know, bigger than just like the little readers that they would do in class. And then you have the Knitting Nights book. Knitting Nights is very similar to the other books that we've discussed. And this book, again, colorful pictures, really great words in the book based on the phonograms that they've just studied. In level C, you will also still use those basic phonogram flashcards. You'll also use the game cards. So everything that you purchased in the beginning with A, you're still using the whole way up through level C. That brings us to level D. Now, I felt with level D, it was definitely a jump in the amount of work. In level C, I was probably doing a lesson over maybe like 2 days, once in a while a 3 day for a lesson. In level D, I was pretty much always doing 3 days for a lesson, and even sometimes four, if I really wanted to do all the assignments that were part of the lesson. Level D, you're going to continue with phonogram cards, but you're gonna start using some advanced phonogram cards. Maybe phonograms that aren't always used in everyday words, and those ones are the separate flashcards. And then you also have the readers that are part of the program. And what's nice too is you start seeing other types of books that they're reading as part of their lessons that aren't just the Logic of English created books, but instead they are ones that you could either pick up at your library or maybe you even have them at your house right now, like Frog and Toad, you know, Henry and Mudge, and these stories. And they have activities which might include some writing activities or just some project based on some of these books that they're reading. So level D really goes down deeper into this type of material, as well as includes some grammar. We start seeing more grammar cards being introduced with grammar rules. And we also have our spelling rules. Now, I didn't really talk about spelling rules. Spelling rules is something that we see throughout the program, probably introducing more when you hit level B and then definitely into C and D. So with spelling with the program, that's great about Logic of English is that if my kid asked me, how do I spell the word cat? I don't just say to them, oh, it's C-A-T. Instead, what I do is I say, sound it out to me. And I hold up my fingers and I say, say cat. And they'll go, sound out cat. And they'll go, ka-at, cat. Great. And so they'll see that as a clue to say, oh, it's individual phonogram letters, C-A-T. When we get into level B, we start introducing, as I said, those multi-letter phonograms. And what's really cool is you then do the same thing with your fingers. If they say, how do I spell mom, the letter play? Well, sound it out for me. P-L-A. So you see I have my two fingers up, which would tell the kid, oh, it's a two-letter phonogram, not just a single-letter phonogram. Which one is that that's used at the end of a base word? Oh, that's A-Y. So they're able to know which one you're allowed to use at the end of an English word. So those types of finger clues really help. And then the spelling rules are great too. My family actually put our spelling rules to songs. So something like A, E, O, and U usually say their long sounds at the end of a syllable. We might sing it like A, E, O, and U usually say their long sounds at the end of a syllable. A, E, O, and U. Just to like some fun little easy nursery songs, we just made up those. And so we will sing them together when we're spelling, and that just helps reinforce the rules as well as those finger clues that I'm not just giving them the word to them, and that really helps as part of the program. The other thing that we use is there's letter tiles, and these letter tiles are just little cardboard letters, and they have both single and multi-letter. These are all the basic phonograms. And what many of the Logic of English users do is we stick magnets at the back of them and we just use a cookie sheet. And the kid can, if they're having a day that they really don't want to handwrite or you want to give them a break from handwriting, they can use those tiles to use for their spelling words and make words with the single or multi-letter phonograms. The Logic of English also has an iPad app. This app we do use regularly, especially when you're starting in the program and maybe, you know, you're like me in school, I really didn't go through reading lessons phonetically. Ours were in school was definitely more sight words. And so listening to those phonogram sounds using the app really helped me as a mom, even if I was lesson planning the night before, especially some of them that have 4 to 5 different sounds. Or I can even bring it up in the middle of the lesson, go, oh, let's listen to the iPad app and we'll hit it and just hear that sound. You can also use the iPad app as a sort of a quiz review you can give to your kid, and it goes through a sort of a quiz process that they can be able to review their phonograms that way. The last thing I have here at the table is the Logic of English, the rhythm of handwriting. So when I said in the beginning that you had to pick if you're going to do manuscript or cursive back in letter level A when you start, my family, we picked the manuscript. And so I wanted my kids still to learn cursive. So they have a separate standalone book that the only thing it is handwriting. And this book I just introduced back when my kid was in level D. I felt like my child was ready. They had good manuscript. They knew how to write their letters. So I wanted to be able to move into just teaching them how to do cursive. So as part of the lesson, I would just pull a page from the handwriting book and have them learn how to make a, you know, a cursive B for the day and a lowercase, uppercase, whatever we were working on. And then when we got sort of towards the end of D and we're more comfortable with the cursive, when we had to do spelling words, instead of write those spelling words in manuscript, let's write those in cursive. And that was our cursive practice for the day. So the handwriting book is separate, and you can do it if you're, you know, if you picked manuscript or cursive in the beginning and instead you really want your kid to be able to do some manuscript practice, you can also do that as an add-on to this whole entire level and package. So as you can see, there's a lot of stuff here. It sometimes, you know, I look at it and it looks like a lot, but I've used this so much that it's not overwhelming at all. So if you do get this stuff, don't be overwhelmed. Know that it'll all make sense soon. There's also some good teacher information too. If you go to the Logic English website, they do have some links that you can go to be able to take some, to review some teacher videos, things like the finger spelling or how to really go through the phonograms. And you can watch those tips and tricks from the teachers at Logic of English. And that really helped me before I jumped into the program. So just watch for some more videos coming up with A, B, C, and D levels of Logic of English Foundations. If you use this program and you love it, or you'd like to share some things of how you use the program, please comment below. Or if you have any questions, if there's a specific book or cards that I have on the table that you really want to see, let me know. I'll definitely try to get you a video or some pictures of what those individual books or cards are like. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you like this, please like and share. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.